covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News at 6.
I have not been found wrong.
You reached a court and paid court fines. Oh, and you just got cited.
It's okay. It's okay.
A WPBF 25 News exclusive. It's neighbor against neighbor in a Lake Worth community. Good evening, everyone. I'm Tiffany Kenny.
I'm Victor Blackwell. Thanks for watching tonight. A Lake Worth family is housing 4 horses and 7 dogs on their quarter of an acre property.
While they're not breaking any ordinances, neighbors say they are fed up with the smell and the noise. Kathleen O'Toole has this story that you'll see only on WPBF 25 News. Kathleen?
Right. Are the animals well cared for and a good addition to the community, or are they a smelly nuisance that don't belong in the close quarters of this neighborhood? Well, of course, it depends upon whom you ask.
Nobody ever sees this when all this stuff was fresh.
He's got videos of everything.
It's clear there's no love lost between these next door neighbors.
That shouldn't be your concern.
No, it's not your concern. But their dispute is a bit out of the ordinary when you see what it's over.
The dog cages are right here, right up against my property.
Luis Arizari has new neighbors, not just the humankind, but 7 dogs and 4 horses.
By the horse manure, when strong wind picks it up, it swings it right over through my house. I have to close windows. Dogs barking and howling in different hours of the night.
Arizari has called county code enforcement in disbelief that the area is zoned agriculture, residential, and all these animals are allowed on less than a quarter acre of property.
There has to be, you know, a resolution to this, because they have been getting away with this for so many months.
There's no complaints from any of these people here at all. Just there.
Dominic and Lori Watson moved recently from a 20-acre property in rural North Florida.
Their bellies are roly-polies.
They brought their horses and dog breeding business with them.
My animals are 100% taken care of. These are our kids. We pay attention to them 24 hours a day. This is our life.
And animal care and control officers agree.
We've been out there multiple times. At this point, they are in compliance with our existing code.
Captain Dave Waleski says while there are rules about how many dogs or cats can be held on a certain size property, horses are exempt.
It definitely seems like a small piece of property for the amount of animals or the size of the animals that are there, too.
But it's allowable.
But in our current ordinance, it is acceptable.
We've learned there is an active code violation investigation against Watson for building these kennels without a permit. Hardly the kind of development that'll bring harmony back to Third Terrace.
I feel that the laws need to change.
If they change, that's fine.
Well, in fact, they might get their wish. Animal Care and Control is going before the county commission next month, asking for some significant changes to the ordinance, not based on this case, but based on their experience. What they will get if passed is it would require horse owners to make an overhang for their animals. Tiffany?
Well, what's the requirement on that right now, Kathleen?
Right. Good question. In fact, right now, all the horse owner needs is a shade tree for that horse to seek some shelter under with our intense sun. Also, if this ordinance passes, it would mean significant changes for pet shops and dog owners as well.
Well, this story is getting a huge response from viewers. Here's a look at some of the comments we've received so far. Let's start with Sue. This is just too much animal for a small space. Do they have the manure removed daily? It is not fair to the animals, especially for the horses, to not have running areas. Zeus adds, with that much animal manure on a quarter acre lot, you'd think it would be a sanitary nuisance. And another person writes, Lake Worth used to be the home of many horses. It was a rural community with chickens as well. People use their small lots to board their horses and exercise them in open fields and down the dirt roads that are now asphalt. The ordinances haven't kept up with the times. What do you think about this? Should a person be able to keep 4 horses and 7 dogs on a quarter acre lot? Go to WPBF.com, click the story on the homepage, and tell us what you think.